Hey, what's up, everybody? Today we got a very special build on the Sean Spook Shack. So I have a 12-foot skeleton, baby. It was hard to find. I had to drive all over, I didn't drive all over. I wound up going to Ohio. We're an hour away from my southern home, which was an hour away from where I'm living currently. Pain in the butt. But worth it.
And
out of the box, this thing takes up the entire back. What a pain. This thing's massive. So yeah, if you want to buy one of these, make sure you got a big car or a trailer or something. I do have a bus seat in there that's going to come out as well. It takes up a lot of the space, so it'll probably fit in a smaller car. But, you know, hey. All right, let's get all the bits and pieces out.
We have a massive femur, I think.
The only thing I did save from the box were the instructions in the form of cardboard Ten Commandment tablets. Pretty interesting.
A box of hardware, it looks like.
Another bone. Box pie.
Another bone with socket locks.
Another bone with socket locks.
Probably for posing.
Okay. Boy, got some big hits. A hand. Look at how big that thing is. The size of my head. Bigger. And you. The P's and Q's. Holy crap. One massive foot marked C. I'm not sure what the shoe size this guy is. He's about a 40, I think. Bone mark J. Another bone mark G. Instructions and ground stakes and piano wire, cable wire. Jeez, oh, Pete. What am I getting into? The massive foot stand that he stands on. This thing is the biggest part. And probably closer to the hardest part to move, I guess.
giant horse liver. Pretty big, comparatively. Oh yeah, this would be the head. Not a bad looking guy, eh? All right, let's get this building here. All right, well, this is pretty funny. We're gonna break the rules. Because the first thing it says right there, assembly requires at least 2 adults. 3 adults are recommended. Well, I'm gonna do this mano y mano. Or actually, mono. There's no e mono. All right. Let's get the crack a lacking here. So we start off with A, the base. Pull off little thingies. Pop on feet B and C. That's the front. The left foot is back. So far. See, D and E, we got a couple of poles. Let me get my knife. except for that. Boom. We got a couple ladies in place. Alright, what's next? Slide on bones F and G. There's F. We'll just start with one at a time. F is your left leg. And the joint up high. Again, really tricky to make it out on the picture, so we'll just see what goes right. Oh, I see. So at the bottom, this is round with a flat. And as you can see, round with a flat. So just get your orientation right, and it's super easy. And as you're putting it down, it looks like you need to twist a little bit to get her to do its thing. Around, it's flat right there. That is nowhere near close. So what are we doing wrong? Maybe I got my legs mixed up. Maybe I don't know my left from right. Try it on the other leg. Well, that fits like magic, so I think I got my legs mixed up. Whatever. Here's G. Same deal, round with a flat. So line that up. And this one you gotta twist as you take it down to get it to fit around the place. Oh, look at that. Easy. Okay. So if you know your left from your right, this is a little bit easier. Okay. Then we got a couple H poles to go on top of these. These are S poles. Well, this thing is getting close to tall as me already, and we are not even to the hips. It's exciting. These can also only go on one way because, again, spring lock, spring pin lock, whatever you call those things, just snap right in. Easy peasy. This one on. Alright. Now we're ready for I and J. Okay, similar. This is a an oval with a couple angle cuts, so it can only go on one way. And you can see the wrong leg I'm trying. Well, see, that just sits right in there, nice and loosey goosey. Lots of plastic shavings. So, you know, kind of bump those out as you're doing this. Also, a lot of trim pieces that didn't quite reach right. Pieces are like that, so this is backwards. I think I got my legs mixed. Oh, all right. I just didn't give it enough force. So yeah, there we go. J's on the left, I's on the right. All right, what do we got? All right, K is the torso. Again, these are the snap locks. These are hidden inside by a little, got a little hole cut out of the back so you can get them on. Okay, this is a tricky part. This is where those 2 to 3 adults are really gonna help. But I'm pretty dumb. Wiggle it around and you can kind of get it going. The tricky thing is you got to do both sides almost at the same time. So if you're careful, you can make this work with a little bit of jiggling. There, look at that. I did it all by myself. Alright, so I'm almost 6 foot tall and his torso, or his crotch, is at my head, but he's definitely 4 foot tallish. Alright, this is where things get interesting. You gotta lay him down to build the rest. I guess I'll follow the instructions. I would say you could probably use just a really tall ladder. We'll try it their way first. Okay, so lay them down forward. So. It helps have a platform that is as wide as he is, which I do not. Well, barely. Alright. So he's laying down now. Make sure I get this massive monstrosity all in the picture here. Alright, what's the next step? Alright, so L, which is his backbone, goes in. And he's got a spike sticking out. There's only one way this can go on as well. Same deal with the spring lock. Alright. What's next? Oh, we're on the tablet number 2. I guess we're on the fifth commandment here. Alright, what are we doing? Putting on the torso. Okay. This is kind of tricky because there's a wire right there. It needs to be plugged in. What is this? Now push or tilt, don't climb on. Don't add or modify. Little area. Remove stickers. Requires 3 adults. Just get our knife out and cut that off. Okay, good. I do give you a little bit of room to flip this one. So let's slide this on. Holding this wire. And let's plug this in once it has enough extension. There we go. Wire in so it doesn't pinch. And this just kind of pops on, it looks like. I should mention too, the weight on this thing is not too bad. One person can easily manipulate this thing, so. Trying to get that thing to that thing on his back that pops through to come through. Wire on this one, definitely pull it up and out for his head. stand this thing up. This is kind of ridiculous. Let gravity help us out here. He's in the tree. I'm gonna go get a ladder. Okay, so I got me a step ladder, and we're gonna try to do this upright. Yeah, that's no bueno. Because the problem is it needs to clear two things. It needs to clear the upper part of his spine and his neck hole at the same time. So let's get her back over here on our table, and if I can do it sideways, I don't know. This part's kind of tricky. With one part. Sideways, it fits on my table better. Alright, I got the neck hole clear. Hey! Hey, there we go. Alright. Yeah, I recommend doing this sideways if you're going to do it with one person. Or if you have a bigger table. I've only got a little Black & Decker table, vice table. So yeah, there we go. Cool. Let's go on to the next steps. Get the camera situated so you can see all our fun progress. There we go, that's pretty good.
All right, what's next?
The spine is shown. Okay. So let's get that loop pinned. That pin is marked T. It's the only one in the bag. So that should be pretty obvious. Screw that in through the access hole. That right there. Oh, of course the threads are just crap. So let's get a screwdriver in. Tighten that. Yep. Missing one bolt right there. So I'm gonna need to find something that fits. Readjust the camera. All right, well, I don't know what part you guys didn't see, but we did end M. I positioned his arm in the upright position. I was missing a bolt for the other arm, which is awesome. But I happen to have one that'll fit. So let's go ahead and put that in. And I'm gonna put him in the down position. Need to be super tight, it's just holding it. Okay. What's next? Twist locks. He's only got two positions he can twist lock into. And this arm up doesn't make sense, so I'm going to put it down. Pieces are pretty durable. That was a durability test. And we're looking up in the trees too.
pretty cool pose. It's almost like he's reaching out for a handshake.
What do you think about that? That's kind of cool, huh?
Get to pull off his eyes. Eye sticker protection. Try this at home, kid. Under the tall ladder. So if you're gonna do this, doing it this way, you're gonna need a 6-foot ladder.
Camera's still in position. Yeah, let's get the head a little bit better. There we go.
His head is super lightweight too, which is also cool. Makes it a little bit easier. Nice rickety ladder. feel. But let's see. It does not. We get some batteries. Power him up.
I don't have 4C batteries, so let's work on placing him. I guess I'll put him near the house. It makes the most amount of sense. Let's see if I can move him by myself.
Are you going to outside?
No.
we go. One 12 foot tall skeleton. There you go. One 12 foot skeleton assembled, moved, decent distance, and positioned with one person. You don't need three people, the instruction says. Poppycock. Let's try to get an appreciation of how tall he is. That's my head level. Looking up. Oh my God, he's just a towering inferno. I mean, he's tall. The one thing too that I didn't record, this guide wire, it goes through his spine and then it connects down to two hooks they have. This is something that's dang near impossible to do by yourself. So what I recommend doing, I took that big screwdriver and I pulled the guide wire tight and I kind of slid it off the screwdriver onto the hook. That was the only way I was able to get this. This guide wire might be easier to assemble when it's on the ground. All right, there you go. It's about sunset and you can see his eyes pretty good. Even during the day, which is pretty cool. Let's get a closer look at his eyes. And those black doll-like eyes. Always looking at you. What is he thinking about? Oh, it's pretty spooky. Oh,